a multi-million dollar software program designed to streamline the payroll system for 15,000 state workers. The problem is, it's not working.
From late paychecks to unnecessary deductions, the state employees union is outraged, but it appears that it's a problem that's not going away anytime soon.
For an enterprise as large as the state, this is unacceptable.
It was just a few weeks ago that union rep Beth DeVideo says roughly 600 state DOT workers took a look at their paychecks to find that their health care costs had accidentally been deducted twice. Another chronic complaint, some state workers say that they're not getting paid for vacation. Or if they change job titles, sometimes they don't get paid at all. DeVideo says that's what New Hampshire is getting for a $25 million IT contract that the state bought into back in 2006.
It has been extremely, extremely expensive, and it doesn't work.
To the contrary, the Commissioner of Administrative Services, Linda Hodgson, says the state got a good deal, maybe too good.
The state really favors low bid, and low bid is challenging.
Hodgson points out the $25 million contract is for the financial system and human resources, and the problems have largely been with the HR portion. And while she says the isolated complaints are corrected quickly, her undermanned office, which lost 55 positions in the budget cuts of 2011, can only do so much.
It's not going to be fixed right away. We're going to continue to work through this, but there are still many months ahead of us before I feel like this is running the way in which we want this to be running.
Bottom line, Hodgson says the state is getting what it paid for. And while Executive Counselor Chris Sununu wasn't in office when the contract was approved, he says it's an example of government not keeping up.
The more it lingers on, whether it's in the legislature or the Executive Council, literally the technology is getting outdated as we debate the issue. So it's important to make a decision to move on and not shortcut the system.
And another bug in the system, employees are having a difficult time applying online for other state jobs. In some cases, the computers simply too old to run the software, but Administrative Services has been holding seminars and working long hours to try and educate agencies about how best to navigate the current program.